This is part 5 on the Who is Esau video series, and in this video I'm going to cover the argument of the Dukes. Many Israelites seem to put up the argument and attempt to try to prove that the European aristocracy actually comes from the Dukes of Edom. So I'm going to pick up in Genesis chapter 36 and kind of continue on from the last video where I left off, when it spoke of the blessings that were given to Esau and how this was fulfilled shortly after those blessings were given to him by his father Isaac. Genesis chapter 36 verse 6 reads, "And Esau took wives and his sons and his daughters and all the persons of his house and his cattle and all his beasts and all his substance which he had got in the land of Canaan, and went into the country from the face of his brother Jacob." Notice verse 7. "For their riches were more than that they might dwell together, and the land wherein they were strangers could not bear them because of their cattle." So you can see the blessings were coming about that were promised through Isaac. And now it was time for Esau to receive his allotted land inheritance. So in Genesis chapter 36 verse 8, it reads, "Thus dwelt Esau in Mount Seir." Esau is Edom. Now let's go down to verse 15. Let's get to the topic at hand. Start at verse 14. "And these were the sons of Aholibamah, the daughter of Anah, the daughter of Zibeon, Esau's wife, and she bare to Esau Yeush and Yaalam and Korah. These were dukes of the sons of Esau, the sons of Eliphaz, the firstborn son of Esau, Duke Teman, Duke Omar, Duke Zepho, Duke Kenaz." Now these, I'll admit, these are some wicked characters here. Now let's get into the word duke. You know, duke, the word duke is not a Hebrew word, but the word translated duke is word number 441, according to Strong's Hebrew Dictionary. Okay, let's look at the Brown, Driver, and Briggs definition first. Means tame, docile, friend, intimate, chief. And this is pretty much the definition that is being conveyed here, a chief. Strong's Hebrew Dictionary gives us familiar, a friend, also gentle, hence a bullock as being tame, applied, although masculine, to a cow, and so a chieftain. All right, so this is another chief. A ruler, all right, someone in charge. It's been translated in scripture. See, this is where you guys hang yourselves. It's been translated in scripture as captain, duke, chief, friend, governor, guide, and ox. It comes from the word aleph. I recommend someone do their own study on the word aleph, and even the Hebrew letter aleph. Start digging into that. Go back to the proto-Sinaitic Hebrew, and you'll see the symbol, what's symbolized by the letter Aleph. All right, back in the scriptures, let's move on to the next passage here. Let's look at Zechariah chapter 9, verse 7. "And I will take away his blood out of his mouth, and his abominations from between his teeth, but he that remaineth, even he shall be for our mighty one, and he shall be as a governor in Judah, and Ekron as a Jebusite. Governor in Judah. There's going to be governors in Judah. Governor. That's word 441. Governor in Judah. They could have translated it Duke. So there'll be governors in Judah. Does that mean there'll be Edomites in Judah? According to this prophecy? Is that what they're talking about? The Dukes of Edom? Is that who they're mentioning there? Let's go on to the next scripture. Zechariah chapter 12, verse 6. In that day, I will make the governors of Judah like a hearth of fire among the wood and like a torch of fire in a sheaf, and they shall devour all the people round about on the right hand and on the left. And Jerusalem shall be inhabited again in her own place, even in Jerusalem. Same word, 441, Aleph, Duke, governors, more dukes in Judah. Okay, let's go even deeper. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 11, verse 18. And Yahweh hath given me knowledge of it, and I know it then. Thou showedest me their doings. But I was like a lamb or an ox that is brought to the slaughter, and I knew not that they had devised devices against me, saying, let us destroy the tree with the fruit thereof, and let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name may be no more remembered. Look, ox, same word, Aleph, Duke, all right? This is getting pretty ridiculous. And this is going to be the clincher right here. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, verse 4. Wilt thou not from this time cry unto me, my father, thou art the guide of my youth? Thou art the guide. Word 441, Aleph. All right, speaking of the Most High, my father. So is the Most High a Duke here? Is he an Edomite? But you guys want to take the word Duke and run with that and apply that to the European aristocracy saying, here's proof. Here's proof that these are Edomites. You know, the word Duke. Who else on this planet is calling themselves Dukes? By now you should be able to see how ridiculous that argument sounds, and it's indicative of a person's lack of understanding, a lack of comprehension, and you know, this is crazy. And like I said before, we're going to go through this topic of Esau one argument at a time and tear the whole thing down. We're going to prove this isn't a so-called Caucasian. So everyone who made different arguments, trying to raise different topics, I told you, we're going to address them one at a time. So, and we'll begin to the other scriptures real soon. Things like the book of Obadiah. We're going to get to that. We're going to cover that. We're going to cover 2nd Esdras. We're going to cover many of the main points that you believers in this doctrine try to bring out. So with that, I'll close. This is just a quick video tearing down the false Duke doctrine concerning Esau. And with that, I'll say shalom. As I walk through this world, nothing can stop the Duke of Earl. And you are my girl, and no one can hurt you. Oh no, yes, I